I'm just coming out to do our little speech about what we have available for you and also where your exits are. I'm Mrs. St. Pierre, and I was the assistant director for this production. Mrs. Isaac and I would like to say how fabulous our crew of kids are. Thank you. They have been awesome, working so hard. We're all so excited. So we have freak flags for you to join us in waving during the freak flag scene, which is at the end. So if you want to purchase at intermission, these are by donation. And we also have little flags for shout outs. If you would like to leave a shout out for one of the performers or stage crew, those are also by donation. And we have 50-50 tickets available. $1 for one or $5 for 10. And those will be for sale through intermission, like the first 5 minutes of intermission. We'll try to wrap it up and then the end of intermission will draw. So, did I forget anything? Oh, exits. And on the sides here too, if you need them, and proceed with caution and don't run anyone over, please. Okay. But there won't be any emergencies. Hopefully we've gotten that all over with. Thank you so much for coming and enjoy the show.
Your ugly son, which means that life is hard. you all read Lord Farquaad's decree.
Yeah, we read it. All fairy tale creatures are hereby banished from the kingdom of Duloc. All fruit cakes and freaks are hereby evicted.
All right, when I call your name, step forward. Pinocchio!
Oh, I'm not a puppet. I'm a real boy.
That's your patch of mud down there. Gingerbread man. I said gingerbread man. Has anyone seen the gingerbread man?
He's been missing for days.
Oh yes, that's right.
Life is disappointing.
Yeah! past that weird old woman in the shoe, and then took a left at Mary's little house of lamb chops. It's just a donkey.
Step aside, Ogre, and let us out.
Why? What did he do?
I don't want to die. I don't want to die.
He's a talking donkey, a freak of nature. As are you, you unsavory beast.
Hey now, you're going the right way for a smackdown.
By the order of Lord Farquaad, I am authorized to place you both under arrest.
Under arrest, eh? Boo. This is the part where you run away. And don't come back! Now, which way to Duloc?
Man, can I just say, that was awesome! They were tripping off themselves to get away from you. I like that.
Oh, that's nice. Now, why don't you go celebrate your narrow escape with your friends?
But I don't have any friends.
Now that's a shocker.
Haha, very funny. Now, are you lost or something?
No, I'm just trying to figure out the best route to Duloc.
Oh, Duloc? I know Duloc. You've got to let me show you the way. Because I am like a GPS with fur.
I'll be fine on my own. Thanks.
But nobody's fine on their own. Not when you look like we do. Hey, did you hear what they said? This place is going to set for it. We gotta join forces, or else they're gonna lock us up. And I cannot go back in the cage. I don't know if I mentioned it or not, but I did 6 years in solitary for impersonating a piñata.
Alright. Only because I'm lost, you can come.
Woohoo!
On one condition. You keep the jabbering to a minimum.
You got it. No jabbering. Man, you will not regret this.
Too late.
Shrek and Donkey, to stop our friends off a whirlwind big city adventure.
Thank you.
you are. You and the rest of that fairy tale trash poisoning my perfect kingdom.
It's not a kingdom, because you're not a king!
Oh, but I will be, just as soon as I find a princess to marry, and I hear you know of one. Tell me where she is!
Bite me.
That's it! That's it! My patience has reached its end! Present the devices of torture!
Let's not get crazy now. Maybe I have
heard of a princess.
From who?
Do you know the Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man.
Yes, I know the Muffin Man. Who lives on Drury Lane?
Well, I heard it from the Muffin Man.
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man!
He heard it from the Muffin
Man. Can I go now?
You haven't told me where she is.
I can't.
You must.
I won't.
Tell me or else.
I'll tell you. She's a day's walk from here in a dragon-guarded castle surrounded by hot boiling water.
Well, that sounds dangerous.
Do you want a princess or not?
Go on.
In the highest room, in the tallest tower, you'll find a fiery redhead named Princess Fiona.
Ooh, Princess Fiona. She sounds perfect. Except for that whole dragon lava thing, I'll have to find someone else to go.
Big surprise!
I shall make Fiona my queen, and Duloc will finally have the perfect king! Captain! Captain, take a look at the swamp with the rest of the fairy tale freaks!
Swamp? That's the thanks I get?
My people, we're going to get a queen! Maestro!
Embarking on a great and noble quest.
But we're already on a quest.
To get my swamp back.
Yes, and you've nearly accomplished it. All you have to do is rescue Princess Fiona from the dragon, bring her to me to Mary, and I'll hand over the deed to your swamp. Guard, give him the file on Her Royal Highness.
Thank you.
big Farquaad will give you your swamp back. You know, pull some of that ogre stuff on him.
For your information, there's a lot more about ogres than people know.
Example?
Example? Okay, ogres are like onions.
They make you cry?
Yes. No.
They smell?
No.
You leave them out in the sun for too long and they get all brown and start sprouting little white hairs?
No. Onions have layers. Ogres have layers. Onions have layers. You get it. We both have layers.
Oh, you have layers. Well, why don't you just say that? You know, not everybody likes onions. Parfaits. Everybody loves parfaits. Have you ever gone up to someone and said, hey, let's go get some parfaits? And they say, I don't like no parfaits. Parfaits are delicious.
I don't care. Ogres are not like parfaits.
Parfaits may be one of the best things in the whole planet.
This may be the longest day of my entire life.
Oh, I got the perfect remedy for that.
Oh no, I'm not interested.
We're the lucky ones. Everyone else, she incinerated.
She keeps us around because we sing backup.
What?
I knew this day.
princess, we really could use a little help here. No, nothing, best day ever.
Thank you.
youth with promise and fresh starts.
It is?
Yes. And the first thing I'd like to do is apologize for my behavior yesterday. We obviously got off and on foot. I'd like to make it up to you.
What?
Yes. So I got a quest with fairies. Made you eat the daisy chain. It's a long way to do lock. A rupture! Yes! Poor Froggy! Farquaad, my groom to be. What's he like?
Well, let's just say, men of his stature come in short supply.
Really?
Yeah, although he is a little intimidating.
Well, he must be.
And yet very good at small talk.
What are you doing?
What? Just saying you might want to lower your expectations a bit. Yeah, about, like, 3 feet or so.
All right, yuck it up. Doesn't bother me. Not today. After a lifetime of misery, things are finally going my way.
Misery? It must have been hard living in a dragon-guarded tower.
It was.
At least you had a roof and a cozy bed, which is more than I had when I left home.
You're not actually comparing yourself to what I endured.
Just saying, you don't corner the market on unhappy childhoods.
There are things you don't know, you know, about me, about how rough I had it.
What, you run out of shampoo a couple times?
I mean, about my life.
And that cushy tower of yours.
Cushy? Are you kidding?
I had nothing in that tower, fighting boredom.
Princess lonely,
walking circles, I had only
bare essentials, army cot, a hot plate, and a chamber pot, and every morning I would boil it. No choice, I had no toilet, just a view of devastation, out one window, isolation. In my bedroom, in very little, I have 20 years, I sat and waited, I grew dedicated, all the days were added.
Forever, thanks for playing. Sad to see a princess suffer. But I had it rougher like the time a mob of torches burned my bridges, see the scorches. You're just whining. I had a flaming hiding. As I fled, I had to wonder if I were torn asunder. Would an ogre go to heaven? Did I mention I was 7? So, I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah. Ah, well, better out than in, I always say.
Yeah, I'm gonna be you, I'm gonna be you.
Mom, I just arrived.
Why not?
I've spent my whole life without you.
What's more nice?
Here, you must be hungry. Try this. It's a Snuggers. They're a bit like s'mores, but instead of marshmallow and chocolate, we use squirrel lizards and mulch. Oh, they'll just melt in your mouth.
Shrek, I know you can't hear me right now, but I've got to tell you something. I'm in your corner, buddy, and you have got to tell the girl what you really feel deep down. You just gotta let her know how you feel. So just open your heart, and...
Princess?
Who's gonna tell her?
Yes, Shrek.
Well, I was wondering... I was wondering if...
Okay.
If you were gonna... We're gonna...
Spit it out.
Eat that?
Man,
what is wrong with you?
Shrek, well, you got a lot of gum.
No, you can't know, and you cannot tell him. Promise me that you will not tell him. Promise!
Fine, I won't tell him, but you should. Man, when this is over, I'm gonna need a whole lot of serious therapy.
Me too, man.
I can't think about Shrek. Not now. I'm a princess after all, and I mean really. Who could ever love me so hideous and ugly? Princess and ugly don't go together. That's why I can't be with Shrek. My only chance to live happily ever after is to marry my one true love.
Shrek, I want to go home with you.
No, me? I live on my swamp, alone. Nobody else. Especially useless, pathetic, annoying, talking donkeys.
But I thought...
But you know what? You thought wrong.
Just when you think life can't get any worse, you get evicted from a swamp.
Well, look who is!
I thought you would help us.
Then we had to kick out.
What did you have? What did you expect from an ogre?
We believed you.
Oh, grow up.
Not grow up.
Then get out of my bed.
There he goes, pushing everyone away. Just like he did to me, just like he did to Puss, just like he did to Princess Fiona. You're so wrapped up in your layers, Onion Boy. You don't know how to express your own feelings.
Who's Fiona?
Mind your business, Ducky.
She's the princess who loves him.
They love each other.
Who loves me? She said I was a hideous, ugly beast.
She wasn't talking about you. She was talking about someone else.
Who was she talking about?
Oh, now he's interested. 2 seconds ago, he was all, don't talk to me. I don't need nobody.
Another case of mistaken identity.
Look, I'm sorry. I guess I am just a big, stupid ogre. Which is why me and the princess could never be together.
Listen up, ogre. We spend our whole lives wishing we weren't so freaking strange. They made us feel that way, but it's they who need to change.
The way they think that is!
That's right, Wolfie!
Let your freak fly away! Let your freak fly, fly, fly!
It'll be the dark day before I let you freaks ruin my wedding.
Freaks, eh? Well, I guess it takes one to know one.
What?
Prepare.